consequences.
You're listening to the For Frequency Sake Network. What's a frequency can at the show? Been so drained.
For Frequency Sake is brought to you by Durham Remodeling, serving the Quad City area's remodeling and repair needs since 1973. Clint's Draft House, grab a bite and a pint on 7th Street in Moline. Lopies, New York-style pizza served by the slice or pie, Davenport. Lifted Energy, energy drinks, coffee, donuts, and more, hashtag get lifted. Atomic Sports Cards and Collectibles, sports cards and memorabilia, vintage clothing, hats, pennants, and more. A Cut Above, offering quality custom woodwork designed specifically around our customers.
Not going to get that championship back by shaking hands, being best friends with the champion. No, I slapped him right in his stupid face. I slid out of the ring, and I let him know my intentions from that point.
He calls me down to ringside, and we're starting to chat. He's just seeing how I'm doing, all that. And then at the very end, he's like, hey, you got a match. I was like, I'm sorry, what? He's like, yeah, you're going to have a match. I was like, that's not normal. Like, why? And he's like, yeah. You'll be fine. You're gonna do good. You're gonna wrestle Aleister Black. It's gonna be great. I was like, all right, cool, yeah.
And now, your hosts of the Card Subject to Change podcast, For Frequency Sake Tag Team Champions of the World, the Wizard CZ and Never Wrong Nick Bolt.
Hello and welcome to a very special edition of the Card Subject to Change podcast, the podcast by the fan, for the fan. We are powered by Lopies Pizza, built by Durham Remodeling, and colored by Ryan Allison Tattoo. And of course, we are talking about Pressermania, brother, the Wrestlemania podcast or Wrestlemania press conference that took place earlier today in Vegas as we are recording this. Much ado about nothing. I don't know. These press conferences can go either way. What were your thoughts coming out of this press conference? Were you satisfied with what we got, what we seen at this thing, CZ?
Yes and no. Honestly, I was really hoping we'd see a little more of the WrestleMania card coming out of the presser today. We only have two matches set for WrestleMania, with one that you can probably bank on, but until it's actually officially announced, it's just speculation at this point.
CZ's talking about is obviously they really teased hard Rhea Ripley and Becky Lynch for WrestleMania 40. They really teased it hard at this presser. They two had a brief interaction on stage. It was very good. Good chemistry between the two, a very good promo between the two, but we're not there yet. Becky would have to win the Women's Elimination Chamber at Elimination Chamber in Perth, Australia, before she made her choice known. But they're really setting it up. I think they used the crowd today as a feeler for that. I think everybody really wants to see Becky versus Mommy.
I'd be down for that. I think you're right. I mean, look at your name. You're never wrong. So no, I think that'd be a good. I think that'd be a good title match for Mania. Obviously, the women's side of things on SmackDown is already set with Bayley choosing to go after Io. not sure if you caught it, but Rhea made a nice slip and called her Io Shirai. So I don't know if that was intentional and she's going back to being Io Shirai, or if that was just a slip on Rhea's part. But the big news here is happened at the end of the presser. You've got The Rock coming out talking all bloodline this, bloodline that. Here's the family tree. Him and Roman do the handshake, not the Mega Powers handshake, mind you, but the brother. but they shake hands, make it seem like, hey, this is what you're getting. And then Cody comes out and is like, no, sir. I get the right to choose who I face at WrestleMania, and it's you, Roman.
Cody did earn that right. Last time I checked, Cody won the Royal Rumble. He did earn that right. And I guess if there's anything coming out of this press conference, we get some clarity that Cody will take on Roman Reigns at WrestleMania. We don't know what night yet, night one or night two. I don't know if they, I don't think they slid that in there, what night it was going to be, but we've got our main event for WrestleMania. The winner of the Royal Rumble, Cody Rhodes, taking on Roman Reigns. I know there's been a little confusion in the last few days, and it all started at SmackDown when The Rock showed up, came to the ring, embraced Cody, said a few words, and Cody walked away. I think everybody kind of thought all was lost for Cody, but there'd been a groundswell, a very organic movement to get Cody back into the main event picture. In fact, The Rock called those people Cody Crybabies today on the Pat McAfee show. The Rock made an appearance on that earlier. I was very, I guess, caught off guard by how much heat The Rock was getting from the crowd here in Vegas. The crowd was very, very pro Cody. I thought maybe in Vegas they'd be very 50-50, but they definitely lead towards Cody, I thought, at this presser.
They did, but the other side of that is when The Rock did his millions, that the response and millions, you know, it was still there. So The Rock still has the crowd, but at the same time, The Rock doesn't have it against Roman. So very, very, like you said, a groundswell of support to see Cody in the main event picture. And who knows? I mean, I'm not the chief content officer of the WWE.
It'd be cool if you were.
It would be, but I leave that to one Paul Triple H Levesque. He can keep that. That's a lot more pressure than I want on my plate. Maybe they called an audible here. Maybe they were going to give us The Rock and Cody, or The Rock and Roman at Mania, and the groundswell swayed their decision. I mean, who's to know?
I know. I think we both were anticipating more matches to be announced, the card to be maybe reveal itself a little bit better coming out of this press conference. I guess in the short time you and I have talked before we went on air, both were a little disappointed with that more matches weren't announced. But what is your number one question now coming out of this press conference? What's the number one thing you want answered? I know what mine is, but I'll let you go ahead and ask your question first, and hopefully we can get an answer for it.
So there was a lot of heat between Roman, Rock, Seth, and Cody. Mm-hmm. All four of them were on stage to end the night. Brian Alvarez on X speculated, and thank you, Tim Regal, for bringing this to our attention, that The Rock might be better off at 51 years old in a tag match between him and Roman versus Seth and Cody. And maybe we see that on night one with Cody and Roman headlining night two. I honestly want to see what the Rock's road to WrestleMania is going to be, since he's obviously taken the time away from Hollywood and put himself into the WrestleMania picture.
You kind of answered your question with what my question is. What's Rock's path now to WrestleMania? He's obviously going to be on the card, involved in some sort of way or fashion. You don't just show up on SmackDown and break up a stare down between Cody and Roman. You don't just go on the Pat McAfee show and call Cody's fans Cody Crybabies. You don't just show up at a WrestleMania presser and not plan to be part of the WrestleMania extravaganza show itself. So yes, I guess my number one question coming out of this is, where is Rock's spot on the card? What night will he be on, and who will his opponent be? That tag match does sound intriguing. They could plant the seeds for Rock and Roman not getting along and then set up a match for Rock Roman down the road. But yes, Rock, we do know that coming out of this presser, it is Roman Reigns taking on the Royal Rumble winner, Cody Rhodes. Will Cody be able to finish the story? We don't know, but we're going to get the opportunity to see it. We also have already announced pre-presser, Bayley made her choice after winning the Women's Royal Rumble, and she is taking on Io Sky. Damage Control pretty much absolved now, with Bayley being out of it, going after the leader. Going after Io Sky, the WWE Women's Champion. Interested to see how soon they announce more matches for this show. Like I said, I think both of you and I are just a little bummed they didn't add more matches for tonight.
Let's put on our armchair booker hats for a minute, Nick.
Sure.
I'm curious to hear what your thoughts are on some of the matches. Like, I know one match that stands out to me that will likely be announced. They've been teasing it on SmackDown. You're probably going to see KO versus Logan Paul 2. If I were to be booking WrestleMania season in the build-up, because they're kind of teasing that. Logan doesn't want to face KO again. He needs to go to the back of the line, et cetera, and so on. But you got to think that's got to be in the works for Mania.
That's very possible, but we also don't know what the men's elimination chamber match is going to be yet. We don't know if that's going to be for the U.S. We don't know if Logan Paul is going to defend that in Australia at Elimination Chamber. We know the women's is for a chance at a title shot, but we don't know what the men's side of things are going to be. And since the women's seems to be on the Raw side of things, CZ, you got to figure the men's Elimination Chamber is going to root itself from the SmackDown side. So it could very well book itself around that U.S. championship. So it's hard to say if it's going to be KO versus Logan Paul again.
And obviously, we've still got, 2.5 weeks until Elimination Chamber, and there's still not a full card for that yet.
We're about 16 days away as we record right now. It's on February 24th, so in the wee hours of the morning that we'll be able to watch that here. But you got to think after this presser, things will be shaken up. I would anticipate SmackDown tomorrow night is going to be on fire. You're probably going to see some announcements for qualifier matches for the Elimination Chamber. I imagine it's for the U.S. Unless they're going to put Gunther in there for the IC. I don't know. We've got Roman versus Cody. We just don't have somebody for opponent for Seth yet. So,
which you could also argue that both Elimination Chambers will be kind of Raw oriented and have the winner for the men's face Seth.
Go ahead.
I was just going to say, you know, looking back at tonight's presser, there was one person that doesn't have a match. There's not really a build for an opponent as of yet, unless you can kind of plant seeds from the Rumble. Bianca Belair came out and did some talking and was basically talking about how the last three WrestleManias she's walked in, made history. Sasha Banks, Becky Lynch, Asuka. All mm-hmm. three of those, she has walked out champion. And there's not a championship match for her, at least that I can see in the cards. But if I were putting her in a match, that tease at the Rumble where her and Jade Cargill were holding people above their heads, staring each other down, oh boy, that'd be a match to see, I think.
It would be a match to see, but honest question to throw back at you, you think Jade Cargill's ready for that spotlight? Jade Cargill was programmed in AEW to have 7-minute matches against inferior opponents and to make herself look good. She probably picked up some bad habits along the way. WWE's trying to rewire her and make her the way they want her to be presented. And even though she had a strong showing in the Rumble, I would love to see her at Mania against Bianca Belair. I just don't know if she's ready yet, and I don't know if they think she's ready yet. Good question, though. Good thought. You're going to ask me next, then who for Bianca? I don't know. What stinks here is Charlotte's injured. We were going to get Charlotte Bianca probably at WrestleMania. Charlotte's on the shelf, and just the injuries came at the wrong time for a lot of WWE superstars here. A lot of hopeful matchups. We've got Charlotte on the shelf. We've got CM Punk on the shelf. I know I'm missing somebody else that's injured right now. Off the top of my head, and it's just a blur right now, but injuries coming at the wrong time really messed some things up. So Bianca Belair, it's going to be interesting to see who she gets. And if it's a Jade Cargill, I'm all for it. I love Jade. I just don't know if they're ready to put her out there with that much pressure under the bright lights against Bianca at WrestleMania.
And I mean, you look at the whole roster of WWE, you look at it as a whole, there's a lot of people that you can look at and say, okay, well, who are we going to pit them against? Who are we going to put here? We don't know where Seth Rollins is going to fall. My speculation would be Drew McIntyre somehow is in that match, possibly a triple threat, adding Sami Zayn into the picture. I can't take full credit for that. Got to give a shout out to our tribal chief, DJ Jarvis, who suggested that earlier in the day off air to me. But look at someone like Gunther, the Intercontinental Championship. You have to imagine it's going to be defended at Mania, but who do you put there?
I don't know. Sheamus available. I know Sheamus and Gunther could put on another hell of a match. Let's do it. I mean, they've done it before. They've done it in the past. Let's do it.
I believe Sheamus is a name currently on the injured list.
I think he's coming back soon, though. I think he'll be available for Mania. So okay. He's not going to be completely off the show or completely off the table. I believe he will be available for Mania. But if anything else today, the presser brought some excitement. We're in WrestleMania season. We're in full swing now. It's very good that we do have we did get a match coming out of it. We only got a match, not more matches, but we at least have some clarity coming out of it as Cody Rhodes has officially challenged Roman Reigns for the WWE Undisputed Heavyweight Championship.
Yeah. It'll be interesting to see where we go from here with everything else. But Nick, I know you and I both don't want to go too long. We just kind of wanted to touch a little bit on the presser, maybe give some opinions on upcoming WrestleMania possibilities. We've got a full weekend coming up here. We've got a double shot weekend with Saturday at 6 p.m. You can catch our take on Halftime Heat from 1999. That's coming off of the 99 Royal Rumble, where Mick Foley took an excessive amount of chair shots to the head. But we're not talking about that. We're talking about the empty arena match that took place at halftime during that big sports ball game thing that goes on every year.
The big game.
And then Saturday or Sunday, we're coming to you early, early, early. Don't worry. It's not at 6 a.m. We're coming to you at 11 a.m. Sunday morning. We've got Chuck Brewster coming on the show, SCW Pro talent, coming to talk all things wrestling. And I'm excited.
I'm excited, too. I hope he comes into this interview room like he does when he enters the ring with all that vigor. Looking forward to it. I can't wait to obviously, I'm going to talk about that mullet that he has. That mullet that he has is beautiful thing.
We're going to mull it over a little bit.
We are going to mull it over with him. I know you've been waiting to say that line. But, no, we got a couple. We got a double shot weekend, so you can get your card subject to change fix on Saturday as we review Halftime Heat before the big game festivities. And then we can also talk about, mini wrestling things, mullets, oh my, with Chuck Brewster on Sunday. So definitely looking forward to this weekend. Big events planned. We're glad that you're a part of it here on the Card Subject to Change podcast, the wrestling podcast for the fan, by the fan. We are powered by Lopez Pizza. We are built by Durham and Modeling. We are colored by Ryan Allison Tattoo. My partner CZ and I, I'm never wrong, Nick Bull. We just got done discussing WrestleMania, brother, the WrestleMania press conference that took place in Vegas today. We have an official match coming out of it. Cody Rhodes has officially challenged Roman Reigns. Will he finish his story? That remains to be seen. If and when he does, we will break it down on here. Looking forward to it in the coming months here as we are on the road to WrestleMania. For my partner, the Wizard CZ, I am never wrong, Nick Bull. Thank you tuning in for a very special edition of the Card Subject Exchange podcast, episode 102.5, WrestleMania. Stay tuned, double shot weekend. We will see you soon. Thank you for tuning in. And good night.